I'm running Linux Mint 17.1, and I'm going over to Menu, Office, LibreOffice. I want to know what version I'm running, so I'm going to Help, About LibreOffice. We see that we are running version 4.2.8.2. That is what is in the Linux Mint 17.1 repository. Now I'm going out to the Internet, Firefox. And I want to go out to the LibreOffice website, LibreOffice.org. And I'm going to the download page. We've got two different versions, Fresh and Still. Fresh has version 4.4.4. And if I go to the Still, we have 4.3.7. Both of these are higher than what I'm using, 4.2.8.2. So either one of these would be an improvement. I'm going back to the Fresh release. And the difference between the two is that the Fresh release has all the latest and greatest updates, and the Still release is more like a long-term support release. This is similar to what Linux does. In our case, Linux Mint 17 is a long-term release, and then they have Linux Mint 17.1, 17.2, which they add extra features and bug fixes that are not in Linux Mint 17. And if you don't really need those extra features and bug fixes, you don't need to update. For this tutorial, we want to update to a new release of LibreOffice. You may be asking yourself, why doesn't the Linux Mint 17.1 repository have the most recent version of LibreOffice? This is a video I took while running LibreOffice 4.4 on Linux Mint 17, and we'll notice that these sidebar buttons don't show up properly. They function the way they should, they just don't show up. Some people might find that irritating. Now, this also worked when I used the Mate desktop, so it wasn't just the desktop. The bottom line is the people at Linux Mint only want software releases in the repository that work properly. I want to bring in LibreOffice 4.4. To do that, I need to use a PPA. PPA stands for Personal Package Archive. I do want to point out here that PPA is an Ubuntu-based program, meaning they're meant to work on Ubuntu-based systems like Linux Mint. But if you are using Linux Mint Debian Edition or some other non-Ubuntu-based distro, don't expect PPAs to work. They may work, but don't expect them to work. When we add in a PPA, we are taking a chance that the PPA could bring in a file or may have conflicts with other files. An example would be if the PPA uses a different version of FFmpeg, then the video player has a conflict and you can't use either the PPA or your video player. Things like this don't happen often, but there is that risk when you're installing software that is not in the Linux Mint repository. I understand these risks, and I still want to upgrade to LibreOffice 4.4. To find the PPA, I'm going back to the Internet, and I'm going to launchpad.net. From here, I will search Launchpad for LibreOffice 4.4. Down here, I see LibreOffice 4.4.x, LibreOffice Packaging Team. This is what I want. Looking at the page, we've got a description. We've got adding this PPA to your system, and down below, it's showing the releases. What we're interested in is adding this PPA to your system, and right here, we see PPA : LibreOffice/LibreOffice 4.4. I'm going to copy that, and now I'm going to open a terminal. And I want to type in sudo add-apt-repository. Then I'm going to paste in the PPA that we just copied and press enter. It's asking me for my password. Now it's telling me to press enter if I want to continue or control C to cancel. I'm going to press enter. Now it's telling me that it added that PPA to my repository. Now I want to do an update to bring in all that information. Sudo apt-get update. So now we've updated our repositories. And if we look up here, we see PPA Launchpad. So it brought in the PPA Launchpad stuff. And the last thing we need to do to install our PPA is sudo apt-get install LibreOffice. Yes, I want to continue. There it is, complete. And I believe I was supposed to have closed the 4.2.8.2 version. Hopefully that didn't cause any problems. Let's go over to Office, LibreOffice. And it shows we are running version 4.4.4.3. I'm going to bring up Writer. And here we see that sidebar that comes with LibreOffice 4.4 and above. From here, my original plan was to show you how to remove the LibreOffice PPA and go back to the Linux Mint repository release. But after working with it on a few computers, I found it a little tricky to uninstall. It can be done, but when I typed the commands to remove the PPA, I still had a few packages out there. I needed to fix some broken packages, and the process to remove the LibreOffice 4.4 PPA was more involved than just a few lines. To keep things simple, if you upgrade to LibreOffice 4.4 PPA, I suggest you keep it. The simple terminal commands may work to remove the PPA, may work on your computer. I'm just giving you a heads up that on the computers I tried to remove the LibreOffice 4.4 PPA, left me with broken packages to deal with. But I still want to show you one other way to install a PPA. I'm going to close our terminal and go back to launchpad.net, the home page, and I'm going to type in Blender. This second one down, PPA for Blender 2.4. And the reason I'm picking Blender is, if we look down at the bottom, their release is 2.71, and going into the software manager, going into the graphics, we see that Blender is only version 2.69 in the repository. And there was a few bugs in there with some things that I was using. And Blender 2.71 does not have those bugs. So again, we see PPA colon. This one is IRIE slash and then Blender. Remember with LibreOffice, it was LibreOffice slash LibreOffice 4.4. So they will be different. This one is just created by a different person. And we can see that it's updated by IRIE and then the last name. To update this one, I'm going to add it to our update manager. And it looks like I have a few updates to install yet. Let's install them first. And now to continue on with our Blender PPA, I'm going up to Edit, Software Sources, and and this second one down here, PPAs. When I click that, we see the LibreOffice that we already installed. I want to add a new PPA. And here we see PPA colon username slash PPA. And I will type in PPA colon IRIE slash Blender and click OK. It's giving us some information. I can scroll down and this looks like everything we saw on the PPA page here. Clicking OK. We now see Blender in our PPAs as well. I'm going to update the cache. I'm going to close this window. And I want to refresh my update manager. I'm going to close this window. Opening up that terminal, I still need to install Blender. So I'm going to go sudo apt-get install Blender. And it looks like Blender 2.71 was installed. To prove it, I'm going to Menu, Graphics, Blender. And right here on the home page, we see Blender 2.71. So there are two different ways to install PPAs. If you like these videos, please tell a friend.